Hello everyone and welcome to another trailer analysis video thing, and today we're taking a look at John Wick Chapter 3. Now this comes to us from Lionsgate and Summit, and so for the purposes of this video I am going to be reducing the actual video volume of the trailer just so that I don't get dinged by fucking Lionsgate. I've already made a video on that with Angry Joe and how he's been unfairly copyright ID'd by them. But today we're also talking about John Wick. And John Wick has been one of my favorite action franchises of the last decade. The first one is definitely a really good, really fun, well-made action film with relatable stakes and a really good revenge plot, even if it's about a guy's dog being murdered. The context of that dog is much more significant in the movie if you actually take in some time to watch it. But the first one is definitely great. And then the sequel comes out, and the sequel is actually pretty good. It's not as good as the first one, but its gunplay and its fun sense of action and adventure, it's so much fun, and the ending really opens up possibilities for a sequel, for a third film. The way it ends with, you know, him going on the run is something to really be admired at. And today, we have, finally, the trailer for Parabellum, which is the third entry into the John Wick franchise. So we're going to quickly watch through it, and then we're going to dissect it. So, have a quick cut here. Alright, so here we are. The John Wick Chapter 3 trailer is here. So let's react. 3, 2, 1. So we got Summit Entertainment, Lionsgate Company. Don't monetize it. Oh, there's a dog. Aw, isn't it cute? Alright. The high table. Oh dear. Oh dear. Nice. Wow. That's cool. Wow. Oh, Lawrence Fishburne's back. Whoo! Wow. Nice. Nice. Oh my gosh. Man. That looks pretty good, guys. So let's dive back into the trailer. So we get this nice cold open with he was in Pirates 4, and some other great movies, I'm sure. But it starts off with his character, this guy's character. Let me find, where is it? Yeah, this guy's character, you know, starts off with, you know, hey, what have you done, John? You know, going back to John Wick Chapter 2, you know, how that film ends, how he violated the Continental Rules. You know, opens up with a shot of John Wick and his new dog from the second movie basically running away, trying to get away from the people that are trying to kill him, considering that the whole world of assassins is after him. There's a $14 million bounty on his head, and it looks like it's going to be one hell of a war. This shot looks really good, really good stuff. A lot of cinematography I'm seeing here is definitely some of the best of the series I've seen. I love the color contrast of this image. So he goes to this person. Don't know who this person is in terms of plot relevance, but he's asking for passage. And she's like, nah, I can't really do that for you, bud. Yeah, you're under excommunicado. We can't do that at all. So we get these two characters. They're talking to each other. And are like, hey, you know, how do you expect him to survive all these people? It's like, well, I think it's just fair game that the entire city wants him. So, he gets excommunicated. So it seems like this darker character here is trying to take out something that's in John Wick. Now, it could be some sort of tracking device to keep people away from his location so that he has a better chance of surviving, considering the fact that he is in a world full of assassins at this point that want to kill him, and not just assassins, but like people that he's wronged before could be after him. So it does look like that he's trying to get something out before the excommunicado takes effect. So that's good. He's running through Chinatown, obviously. This scene seems pretty interesting. So this scene kind of looks like it's in Grand Central Station. I'm kind of curious to wonder why there's green lights inside of it. But it is kind of beautiful to look at with the green, with the green everywhere. But it does look like it's in Grand Central. And then we get this really cool thing. I've never seen a single movie before where you have this whole line, like two lines of motorcycles that automatically take out katanas to try swiping at John Wick. That's a really cool idea, and I like this shot too, where you have John Wick in the middle. It's basic. I know it's basic, like, you know, parallel, you know, framing. You got the diagonals there. But, you know, it's very visually pleasing because you have these two rows here that are clearly on a convergence point with John. You know, you got some really good stuff with this shot here. And the fact that, you know, these motorcyclists are carrying katanas that are willing to slice up John Wick right on the freeway looks really fun. It looks like a really fun action sequence. I'm excited to see what actually is fully shown in this. Of course, we get Lawrence Fishburne back as the bird guy. As you might have known from the last film, he was kind of a guy that that facilitated some of the weapons for John Wick for his black mark that he had. So there's that. We get some new characters. We get this really interesting fight scene at this curio shop, I'm assuming it is. You know, John Wick's going around. There's some good, okay, this shot, where is it? Where was that shot with the book? Hold on. Yeah, this one. This looks like a very creative death. You know, having the book lodge in his mouth and, you know, slamming his fist into it. That's pretty cool. Not entirely sure what this shot's about. Maybe they'll expand upon it. Maybe it's like a set location for another gunfight scene. And of course, we get the first teaser image, which was John Wick riding a horse in the middle of New York, which was pretty cool. And then somehow John Wick's in the Savannah. Please don't let there be a terrible Pitbull cover version of Toto's Africa. That would really make me mad. Even if they do put Toto's Africa in there, I'd still be mad because, I don't think you need to reference that song every time you go to Africa. It's just kind of dumb. That's just my personal opinion. And then, of course, we get Halle Berry's new character. Apparently, John Wick and Halle Berry's character have had some sort of connection here in the past. So, apparently, he does have an ally. She has two dogs, which is definitely in John Wick's court because he loves dogs, obviously. So Halle Berry looks like she's going to be utilizing these German shepherds for more than just, emotional support. She's actually going to be using those dogs for actual, kicking ass sort of stuff. And then we get this really cool shot of John Wick coming out of the vault. I'm assuming in the Continental before the excommunicado takes effect, but he has this big ass gun. He's walking towards the camera, and we get the title card of the movie, which is great. And then we get, the German Shepherds. They're fighting. They're actually being utilized. So, May 17th, John Wick Chapter 3 comes out. This looks like a really fun movie to watch. Hold on a second. Yeah, this definitely looks like a really fun movie to watch, and I'm excited to see what happens next with John Wick in May. So definitely keep track of this one. It's going to be one of those movies to watch if you are a fan of the first two John Wick films. So, yeah, this has been your trailer review of the day, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.